皆さんこんにちは。皆さんは英語で科学論文を書くのは難しいことだと思いますか？英語の科学論文には独特のスタイルがありますが、実際には読みやすく理解しやすい論理的な文章であればいいのです。それでは具体的には何に気をつけて英語論文を書けばよいのでしょうか？この講義では英語論文の書き方のエッセンスをマルコム先生が教えてくれます。なお、この講義は京大学術出版会発行のワークブックサイエンティフィックライティングインイングリッシュを参考にしています。詳しく知りたい方はぜひワークブックをご覧ください。マルコム先生は40年以上にわたり遺伝学研究者として活躍し、多大な業績を上げてきただけでなく、複数の日本の大学に客員教授として滞在した経験から、日本人が間違いやすい英語表現に関する問題にも造詣が深く、京都大学で行った英語による科学論文の書き方に関する講義をもとにワークブックを執筆されました。それではマルコム先生、お願いします。
Well, welcome to this open courseware course on scientific English writing brought to you by Kyoto University. This course is based on the book Professor Malcolm's Guide to Scientific English Writing, and it's published by Kyoto University Press. Here you can see a picture of the cover. So the unique features of this workbook are that it is a guide to writing science, scientific papers and presentations for science. The book has all the explanations and messages in Japanese language, and the examples and exercises are in English. The answers to the exercises are in both English and Japanese. The book is self-explanatory, which means that you can study by yourself. It is, of course, desirable to have a teacher, and the teacher will give you extra tips or will evaluate your writing. But you can study from the book by yourself and get a lot of tips and information out of the book. The final point is just to reiterate that this is a book in Japanese, primarily for Japanese people. But also, you can download the English version as a PDF, and so this PDF in English is for non-Japanese speaking people. So here is the table of contents of the workbook. It's divided into two parts: writing in English and how to write scientific papers and presentations. The writing in English part is divided itself into three parts: basic writing principles, how to write clearly and concisely, and some special points for science writing. The second major part is divided into three sections. The first is how to write the peer review paper. This is the central part of the book. It continues with how to prepare and give science PowerPoint presentations, and finally, how to review papers and presentations. So turning our attention to the OCW course, here is the outline. It is divided into seven parts. The first is the introduction, which you're looking at now. Part two is basic writing principles. Part three, how to write clearly and concisely, many tips, and specifics of science writing. The writing of the scientific papers is divided into part four and part six. This is the core of this OCW course. This is the fundamentals of this course. And we have this divided into two parts, how to write scientific papers. And lastly, some tips on scientific presentations. This is based on many years that I've been studying and listening to students giving presentations. So that's the outline of the course. Thank you for your attention.
次のパート2からは、マルコム先生が実際に英語による科学論文の書き方について詳しく教えてくれます。パート2でまたお会いしましょう。
See you in the next part.